Hi, my name is Dr. Kevin Kwak. I'm a fisheries veterinarian with the California Department of Fish and Wildlife.
Yes, I am a fish veterinarian, a doctor for fish. There are not many of us. It's a very specialized and limited field, but California is one of the few states that actually employs fish health veterinarians. So what brought me to CDFW and keeps me here? Well, it was this unique opportunity to combine my experience, education, and passion into a career. The people I have met that work with CDFW, I mean, there are a lot of amazing and talented people. I love hearing what they do, seeing their passion, and when I can be a resource to them, it's been rewarding, fulfilling for me. I've also been able to travel the whole state. We have 22 state hatcheries throughout California. So just by going to work, I've been able to see and explore California. And finally, my supervisors have been tremendous in providing support. They've given me opportunities to grow as a professional and within the department. Recently, I was able to develop a new way of treating fish that are thiamine deficient. And this small change is able to save the department a lot in terms of purchasing thiamine or using the manpower used to perform our older treatments. And so with these fish that are thiamine deficient, we can just add thiamine right at fertilization and have that boost up the thiamine levels in the eggs. A favorite fish that I like working with, one of them would be the golden trout. We did a rescue a couple years back due to drought conditions, and they were rescued and brought down to one of our hatcheries, American River Hatchery, and placed in recirculating tanks. And it was pretty funny because these fish you would think are skittish, hiding, but in these tanks, they were almost as friendly as a dog. I mean, they would welcome you when you walked in. They knew when it was feeding time. So it was really neat just seeing this fish, our state freshwater fish, in one of our hatcheries. It's not something we get to do that often. What do I find most interesting about the fish? There's so many different aspects. I mean, one, they're in such a foreign environment. They are challenging to raise and to treat, just being in that water environment. They're a great resource. I mean, they're beautiful to look at, but if you want, there's some species that you can actually eat. So it's this great cycle that you can be a part of. If you want to raise fish, you can help grow them from young eggs all the way to adults, or you can raise them to eat, or you can go catch them. And they just look so different. There's so many different species, so many different colors. I just think they're really fascinating. So the drought has been very challenging. Of course, fish are involved. The fish health lab has been involved. At this hatchery, Nimbus Hatchery, and American River Hatchery, we had to evacuate both hatcheries due to warm water temperatures. It's just not optimal to grow fish in really warm water for salmonids. And some of these fish were released early, but others were transferred to other hatcheries. And before we do that, we want to make sure that they're not sick or going to bring in any new pathogens to those other hatcheries. It can be a little discouraging just because it seems like drought is something that's going to be in our foreseeable future, but it's also been amazing to see how we work together, whether it's moving fish or other hatcheries taking fish, translocating. So it's been great just seeing how the department pulls together and figures out a way to get things done.